Hey guys, and welcome to another video. So today we are looking at Hikvision's Live-Guard camera range. Okay, so these are IP cameras and they have essentially got a speaker and lights built into them. So they are almost like an alarm and camera all in one. Okay, so very popular right now these are. They've only been on the market a few months and they really have lots and lots of features. So we're going to be looking at the warning feature of the camera today. I'm going to show you how to set up the camera, set up the warnings, so you can get audible and light warnings. All right, so these are activated by motion. So when someone goes near the camera, then it's going to set off the warnings that you set, the preset warnings. Okay, so lots to come up in the video. And then we even have another example of using the alarm, but it's not activated on motion. You can just hit that button on the app and then the alarm will trigger. Okay, so very easy to use, and we're going to show you how to do that in this video all coming up. And we've even got a couple of live examples of the camera in action. So one just me in the office, and we have a real life example of one of my colleagues here. Actually, this happened. Someone went into their property and the camera triggered. So stay tuned, a lot coming up, and we're gonna have a quick look at the camera specs now and a quick look at the camera in its physical form, and I'll check you there. So thanks for watching. So this is the camera we'll be using today in our little example, and there are many different cameras that have this feature. I'm going to leave the whole list below, and if you did want to use NVR as well with this and get all the features, you will need an iSeries NVR. But for the video today, we will be using a switch. So as you see, you can power this camera with PoE, so that comes either from a switch or the NVR. Okay. You can use the K-Series as well. It will work with this camera, but we recommend, if you want the full functionality, to go for the I-Series. Okay, and if you want to activate the one-touch alarm, you have to make sure all the firmware and all apps are all updated to the latest version for it to work. Okay, so that means camera firmware and NVR firmware. All right, so the camera we'll be using today is an 8MP 4K camera. They're also available in 4 megapixel. And all these cameras with the Live-Guard have two-way audio. So you can talk through the app, or you can set up the audible warnings, which we're going to be doing later. The camera we're using is a nice 2.8 millimeter wide angle lens. So this is what most people are going for right now. And obviously it's ColorVu, so you get the 24/7 color with the white light. And it has AcuSense. So it's another new feature from Hikvision, which is basically smart recognition of humans and vehicles, making life a lot easier for notifications and playback and things like that. So yep, a very good camera, lots of features. And now we're going to have a quick look at the camera in its physical form, and then we're going to start setting it up. I'll catch you there. All right, so this is our equipment. I've already taken the camera out of the box. I've still got the plastic on, and as you can see, we've got various connectors here. We're going to be using the PoE here. These are alarm inputs and alarm outputs. You probably won't be needing them, and spare power cable just in case you're not using PoE. Okay, so as you see here, we've got the front of the camera. Let's take off the plastic here. Okay, you got a little microphone in the front here. And if we look to the side, we have a speaker underneath. And we have a little hatch for an SD card or reset button. Okay, so what the camera does come with is some basic screws and connectors and a very handy tool that you use to open up this little hatch in order to put the SD card in there. Okay, I've already gone ahead and done that. It's pretty straightforward. If you are using NVR, obviously you won't need to do that. Same with the switch. If you're not using NVR, we're gonna be using a switch today. Just connect it into one of the ports. Connect it to the camera. And then all you have to do is make sure your switch is connected to your router and your same PC is on the same router. And then we're gonna be able to communicate with the camera and set it up. Okay, so that's the basic setup of this camera, and a quick show you the box that it came in. All right, so this is the 8 megapixel, okay, two-way audio. All right, switch over to the PC, catch you there. Okay, so over to our PC now, and we're on SADP tool. And now if you haven't used this before, I'll leave a link below how to download the program, set up your web browser, so you'll be able to do things like this with your Hikvision cameras. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. It's definitely not anything too complicated. Okay, so it's found our camera. So any brand new camera will be inactive. It means the camera hasn't got a password, and the first thing you have to do is set a password. So let's go ahead and do that. And please note, don't forget your password. It can be a pain to reset once you've mounted the camera. Okay, so now the device is active. So now all we have to do is give it a local IP address because we're using the camera locally. Okay. So to do that, we're going to enable DHCP. We just click on that, pop in the password that we just made, modify. Okay. And now our camera is going to get a local IP address. So right now it's 192.168.164. We'll refresh it. And now it's given a local IP address, 114. Okay, so click on that local IP address, open up your web browser. Okay, so the username will be admin, and the password will be the one you just created, and log into the camera. Okay, so as we see, we've got a nice picture here. All right, so we're gonna go to configuration at the top and start configuring the camera. I'm just going to do some basic settings right now, and then we're going to go ahead and set up the warnings. So first of all, quickly set the time, UK, NTP, we'll take the time from the internet, daylight savings time, you can enable this if you want, do it quickly. Okay. The important part is the video and audio part of this camera. Okay, so we'll quickly check out the audio. Okay, that's fine for the two-way audio. Let's have it a bit louder, and I'm gonna put the noise filter on. Okay, under video, it's under 4K, everything here is fine. What we're gonna do is just go put on video and audio. Okay, so we'll save that. All right, so pretty much some basic settings done there. Now let's go ahead and set up the audible warnings. Okay, so now we're going to set up some motion detection so we can get some audible and light warnings going. All right, so pretty obvious what I'm going to do here. We're going to set this up on the door, and let's go to configuration. All right, so to set up motion detection, you need to go to events. So we have events here on the left, and it goes straight to motion detection. Okay, so we're going to enable motion detection at the top. We're going to draw an area. Okie dokie. And we're going to select human, and we'll save that. Okay, please finish drawing region. Okay, so sometimes you've got to right click when you finished. All right, so save. All right, so that's our area set. Now go to admin schedule. This is when do you want it to happen. Right now it's set to 24/7, so that's fine for our purposes. And linkage method, what's going to happen, you know, when the motion is detected. Okay, so obviously we're going to set up the flashing alarm and the audible warning. And we're going to notify Surveillance Center as well, which is basically our app. Okay, so that's something we're going to have to set up as well. Okay, but right now we're just going to do a basic test. So this is going to be a nice flashing alarm, medium frequency, flashing duration 15. Okay, it's a bit much. I can do 5 seconds. Okay, and it's going to be constantly active 24/7. So the audible warning. All right, so if you are interested in audible warnings, check out our website. I've put some sounds up there, all different types of stuff. Let's quickly test out what we got. So that's a siren. Let's just put this on once for now for the test. Okay, so you got loads of different sounds. Messages. Okay. So we'll keep it on danger, please keep away, that sounds all right. Let's just put it on 3. All right, sound volume on the maximum. Okay, save. All right, so now our motion area should be set up for some sort of basic detection. Yeah, let's go check it out. All right, hold on a sec. Okay. So that worked fine. All right, now, bear with me. All right, now I'm gonna show you once the camera stops ringing. I'm gonna show you how to get it up on your app, and then we're gonna show you how to do a one-touch trigger the alarm direct from your app. So no need to set up motion detection or anything like that. You see someone, you push a button, and it will trigger the alarm. All right, see you guys there. All right, now, so as you see, I've got my phone set up on the right, and we're going to go ahead and get this camera online to set up the one touch alarm, and so you can just basically view your camera online as well. Okay, so this should be pretty straightforward. Okay, what you want to do is get on your phone is the Hik-Connect app. It's called Hik-Connect. You will have to go to the actual Hik-Connect shop store to get that, so I'll leave a link below. But for now, we're going to first of all put the camera online, which is on network here. Then we go to advanced settings, then platform access. Okay, so from here we can select Hik-Connect. We're going to enable that. Yes, please. A verification code. Okay, this can be anything you like. I'm just going to put in 123456. Okay. And we go save. And it should take a few seconds. And it should change it to online. So sometimes it helps to refresh it. Okay, now it's online. All right, so go ahead and open up your app. That's what we're going to do now. And then we're going to go add device. Okay, so we're going to scan the QR code right from the back of the camera. Okay, you can add via serial number or the other methods. So we put in the code that we just asked us for. Okay. And next, save. Yes, next. Okay, so now the camera is going to be on an app very soon once we put in the code. There we go. All right, and you see at the bottom, we've got a couple little buttons there. Let's go to the live view on here as well. Okay, so the two middle buttons are the ones we want to be concerned about. Okay, you've got like a siren bell icon and a light bulb icon. Okay, so the first light bulb icon refers to the night vision modes and things like that. We're going to be looking at that in another video. Okay, right now we're just going to click on the first one. As you see, as soon as you click on the button, the siren goes off. Okay, now let's click on, let's wait for it to finish. Say that hasn't done the job, you want to have the light as well. Click on the light and you see the light starts flashing too. Okay, do that again. All right, so one touch alarm at your fingertips through a CCTV camera. I mean, the things you could do now are unbelievable. So we've got a live example of a similar camera in action, not the exact one. And this was set up just using motion detection. And it managed to catch someone, and God knows what they were up to, but this is a real life example. So I hope you guys enjoy it, and thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and like if you saw anything you liked, and catch you on the next one. Cheers for watching. Thanks. Bye.